Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whenever you're hearing this, everyone. I actually recorded this video, or the longer version, on the 18th of November, but I didn't upload it. It's 15 minutes, but today I want to come to you with an abridged version of my message to you about bitterness and the dangers of bitterness. And by now I've titled this message something like, "Please don't pass the bitterness," you know, like butter, bitter, butter. Okay, I hope you get it. Anyway, you know, bitterness is in a way, it's sort of like butter. You can just spread it on. Once it gets into the person, it spreads all over everything. You can melt it, and it just soaks into the person. And before you know it, that person is totally covered, smothered with bitterness. And just like butter, if it's on your hands, it gets on everything you touch. And the scripture lets us know and warns us about bitterness. In the book of Hebrews chapter 12, verses 14 through 15, it says, "Follow peace with all men, and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord, looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled." So we see bitterness can take root in us. And not only does it stay under the surface like anger, a lot of times people can be angry and you will never know it, because anger can lie way beneath the surface, and it may take one little thing to trigger that anger or to stir it up or to cause it to come to the surface. But bitterness is different. When you're bitter, the scripture lets us know the heart knows its own bitterness, and a stranger does not share its joy, meaning that you know when you are bitter, right? You know when you are bitter. Proverbs 14:10. You know when you are bitter. It's hard to hide bitterness because you're consumed by whatever is causing you to be bitter. For some of us, it could be disappointment. It could be rejection. It could be failure. It could be whatever. You know, I know my own experience with bitterness was that I was just disappointed, you know, believing God for something that didn't happen and just disappointed. A lot of life issues can make us bitter. Death, just so many different things can bring about bitterness in a person's life. But the danger with being bitter is that it can contaminate others, you know. So Hebrews chapter 12 tells us that bitterness can spring up and trouble you, and then thereby many are defiled. When you see, for example, a woman who's bitter towards her husband, what does she do? She talks about it all day long. She tells you how terrible he is. Now, if you are having problems with your husband and you've said something to me, this has nothing to do with that, okay? I'm talking about just bitterness itself, okay? Not hurt and pain. I'm talking about bitterness. But we want to be careful not to allow our hurt and pain to turn into bitterness, right? Okay, so... But bitterness, a bitter person, a bitter woman, she just talks and says all sorts of terrible things about him. So when we see him, right, what do we do? Mm-hmm. Look at him. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, girl. You know, so we have already been contaminated by her bitterness towards him. And that's what the scripture says. Bitterness springs up and it troubles you, and thereby many become defiled. We have all been defiled by your bitterness towards your husband. So when we see him, we're looking at him cross-eyed, cocked-eyed, because we are contaminated. And not only for husbands, people do that with their friends and with associates. They're bitter towards someone, and then they talk to someone else, and then the next thing you know, a whole host of people has turned against someone because of one person's bitterness towards them. Listen, my friends, do not allow yourself to be contaminated by other people's bitterness. It will contaminate you, all right? And not only is it with women, because, you know, we tend to think that women are the only ones who are bitter, but husbands can also be bitter. Colossians 3:19 says, "Husbands, love your wives and be not bitter against them." Now, many of the wives are bitter because the husbands first became bitter. See, when a husband is bitter, he sets the whole house off course. The entire house is just set off course when the husband is bitter, because the husband is the head of the home. Just like God is the head of the man is the head of the wife, and the wife, the home, the whole situation is set off course by the husband's bitterness. So God tells husbands to combat bitterness with love. Truly, love conquers all. Love conquers all. So this week, this was supposed to be the word of the week two Sundays ago, but today I'm going to tell you that we're going to tell anyone with bitterness, please don't pass the bitterness. I don't need it in my life. God bless you. God keep you. Have a wonderful day in the Lord Jesus Christ.